quick booth tour of our booth, 820, the California ABAA Fair, 2018. Wonderful copy of Yellow Wallpaper, inscribed by Charlotte, actually to another writer on her wedding day, which I always liked particularly. Scan the top. Math prints collection, Harvey Milk, Broken Prophets, some book plates, 1361, three volumes, Arm Schematics, and Babe Rambo, brow piece. A Chinese book artist, first book out of the country. Julie Stackpole's Binding on Beowulf. Trade cards. Sorry about the light glare. 1361. Michael Kutch. Elastic Membrane. Christina Amato. More of the trade cards. That's both the original art. Set of six, the original art, and the cards themselves. Starting in the back of the case, first facsimile of Einstein's theory of relativity, the Hebrew University is allowed to be produced, done with Ido Asagi in Israel. Jackie Scott's Rubaiyat binding, beautiful, just stunning bit. Karen Randall, Lexi, Michael Kutch, Red Howler Press, 43, the disappeared students in Mexico, more Julie, Fred Ryan, Lexi, Gabby Cooksey, Thornton, that's 13. 13 Tattoos by Bird Press, Maureen Cummings. This is the binding on one of the deluxes. This is Homelessness for Jamie Murphy, Savage Press's remarkable new edition of A Modest Proposal, which will come inside on that. Open to Cabinet of Curiosities. Layout of some of the poetry by Jessica Traynor. That's the Irish porcelain inlay that's part of the box for the standard edition. Esselmont, Russell Murray. Jane Hammond, Bizzani, more Michael Kutch, Child of Books, which is Sam Winston and Oliver. Wonderful. It'll work. Shin Suzuki's In the Beginning, it's called Away Number 7, cut metal book art piece. Excuse me, Inez's remarkable color change. Just a wonderful, I'm going to be doing a video going through that shortly. Maureen Cummins, Therapist the Rapist, her most recent work. The Nth Convention is an interesting piece by David Henningham on the Cold War. Psychic drawing experiments that were conducted. Pyroleosis out of Australia. Guyana Press, a little bit of Guyana Press. Victoria Beam's New Concrete. I think this is the last deluxe with signed pieces by the likes of Grumbringer. This is Leidenjar. is Karen Randall's newest piece. It's a letterpress book, but then a fully functioning set of Leyden jars. And when you touch one of them, it reads a poem, a different poem linked to each one, exploring the history and significance of Leyden jars, development of science, etc. And she not just wrote it, wrote the text that supports the poetry, but she did the coding of the Arduino processor that runs the system. Collection of bindings. New binding for Death of a Moth by Jackie Scott. And then in here there's Sam Feinstein and Aaron Fletcher and Sonia Sheets and Colin Nabina, Jackie Cooksey, Julie Stackpole. Facebook, early police officers' book. Particularly interesting because the cops would edit it on the fly. They would edit the pictures to add scars or mustache, etc. Casket catalogs. Wonderful collection of 19 volumes of travel around World War II, a Jewish woman world travel. Next to some hate speech, and a wonderful circus collection of circus photographs, circus trained photographs, buried elephants, some archival material. Charles Gatewood, the Marquettes for forbidden photographs. Full run of work. Our voices from the Whores of Yore folk in Yorkshire. Sex trade history. Little bits of this and that. Forced chastity belt wearing, arguably the first upskirt shot, which was Carmen Miranda. Occult witchcraft. And some trade cards. Funeral urn, a collection of original art for funeral urns. Great early Ouija board with all its accoutrements. This manuscript piece in the back, and the Book of Werewolves, 1865. Really a gem of a find. We were very, very pleased. And then just the front case. Miniatures, as always. Nice little funny collection of H.P. Lovecraft, including some photographs. White stains in a fine binding. Essay Upon Wind on vellum, because books on farting are better when printed on vellum. Some nice early Victoriana hair bits. Stephen King's first couple printed pieces, some interesting advertising, and a fire balloon. Roger Ebert's zine, Stymie 2, when he was about 18 years old. And with Journal de Dames, 1912, one of the great Pouchois, pieces. That's it.